Was it the black leg? I'm not sure. I don't think so.
I'm gonna run some blood samples into Flagstaff. Why don't you check your stock out? When I get back, maybe by then I'll have some answers for you.
You ain't gonna quarantine me, are you?
Hope not.
Whoa! Hope not. Hey, everybody. The hell is that? Hold on one second here. Woo-doo-doo. I have to get my beer. Welcome back, everybody. I got my beer. It's Wednesday. Diane, what's today's the date? October's over? No! Halloween has come to an end, everybody. It is November 2nd, 2022. 11 p.m. in Brooklyn, New York. The only podcast from the sewer in Brooklyn. I don't know. Maybe there's others. There might be. There probably is. The podcast grows in Brooklyn. I still got a massive congestion. I probably got like some weird sewer system bacterial infection. I might die soon. So why not have a beer now, right? Ah! Oh, shit. My beer is exploding. This is not good. Taking this one for the podcast. Ah, my leg is so cold. It's going right through my pants. I washed my hands. I could drink it from my hand, right? Oh, that is so cold all over my cooter. I got one of the coldest cooters in podcasting right now. Diane, there's a mess up here. Can you get the Zamboni machine? I've done this with wet pants before. I'll do it again. It's November. Is there the wet vac? Might work. Is daylight savings time canceled? Is that a thing anymore? Or is that gone? Is daylight savings is gone? Is that gone? Is it illegal yet? I read that like in Kentucky and Mississippi and some other else. It's like it's in the legislation to be gone. Maybe next year it'll be gone. Maybe when they finally actually start selling weed in the streets of New York, that daylight savings time will be gone. I don't know. 11-6. I keep seeing 11-6 pop up. And that's weird because they only typed it once. I might be dying. Actually, we're all dying, right? That's one guarantee I could guarantee everybody on this podcast. That we're all currently dying together. Maybe we're even dead. You can't be not born yet. You can't ever hear this podcast unless you're at least born and post-dead. There's a lot of weird articles about being post-dead these days coming out. What is that? Sudden adult death syndrome? I don't think Bruce Willis can see us. Deadass. If you'd like to join the chat room, go to nicktherat.com or nicktheratsocial.com. Click on social. Let's get social, everybody. Or I think it's under there. There's a Discord chat. You could hop in there. I don't charge money or have some weird bots. You could have fun. There's an IRC. On Zero Node, I think it's run by Void Zero. I don't know. Is Void Zero Node? We go together, wouldn't it? Or Twitch. You go to Twitch TV, Nick the Rat. Watch it live. Watch me smoke weed. You know what? I should smoke some weed. Can't believe Halloween's over. Did I have a good Halloween? I had a decent Halloween. I hope everybody had a good Halloween. I had some Reese's Pieces. And did some trick-or-treatings. You know, when you wear a costume and you're on your knees, nobody knows you're not like a six-year-old, right? Just ask the Pope. I watched a lot of scary movies. I'm going to still watch even more scary movies. Did I watch any new scary stuff? Guillermo del Toro has come out with on Netflix something about like a curiosity box or something. I always thought that was what I saw under my grandmother's dress, but I watched the first episode. It was okay. I heard it's really good, though. Cabinet of Curiosities. Thank you, Nam. The special effects were really good in the first one. The slime looked real. But, ooh, man, I love weed. It's so good. What else did I watch? It's like Matlock. It's actually kind of like the show with Two Takes, Jonathan Frakes. He's like, have you ever seen this? Do you know what this is? It was like an unsolved mystery. Guillermo del Toro comes out. He tells a little history, a factual story or something. And then he like opens this a box, and then a story gets told. And, you know, oh, hold on. Where's my list of things here? Oh, yeah. Well, I watched Mint Salad's review of Halloween Kills and Halloween Ends. She liked Kills more because of the death scenes, the killing in it, which I can understand. I think both movies had about one cool death scene. Halloween Kills, I think the fight with the firefighters was pretty funny, and there's like one cool death in that. And then in Halloween Ends, I thought the kid just falling off the balcony and breaking his neck in the beginning was pretty funny. So I would say I think Halloween Ends was still better. She gave Kills a 6 and Ends a 4. I would have switched those around to 4 and 6 on the other side. But I also started watching The Evil Dead, the remake. It was fun. I was enjoying the first 10 minutes until it hit like a commercial, because I was watching it on one of those free things and they play like 20 commercials during it. So I was like, but I'll probably wind up rewatching it again on a better service. I'm sure I have it somewhere. Diane, how many services do we have down here? We have all of them. They're all hooked up to the deli above, right? We got their passwords. All right. Well, yeah, we'll find a way to watch that later. There was more too, right? What else have I been watching? Why am I talking about stuff that I've watched? Nobody cares. Whatever. Oh, before we start the first song, I've been also watching The Watcher, and it's horrible. It's just making me mad. It's shot well, and you know, it's the acting is okay, but the story, it's pissing me off. Like every scene, I don't even know how many episodes there are of the show. It's like a family moves into a house, and then I don't know what the fuck's going on. It's that mystery box bullshit where it's like, oh, we're going to make it even more. And they don't give you any answers. Every answer they give you is basically just some more bullshit. It just pisses me off. And everybody acts like an idiot in it. It's like, you're an idiot. You're an idiot. You're an idiot. I don't know if anybody's watching The Watcher. But if you know how many episodes it is, let me know. I think I'm up to like episode 5 and I just want to rip my nipples off and throw them out the window like UFOs. And okay, look, we're going to take a quick music break. We got a lot more show to go tonight. We're going to be talking about, I don't know, talking to the dead and stuff. And how we're just being ripped off in reality. I'm pissed. But after Dark Spiral... Welcome back to the sewers, everybody. This is Nick the Rat Radio. I am he, Nick the Rat. I am, hi, there we are. So let's just get this whole cat out of the bag. I saw me on this internet thing, an article about talking to the dead using technology to talk to the dead, which has been around since, like, I don't even know, since records has been zones out. Hasn't there's been like EVPs caught in like dictaphones and shit, right? I think, I don't know. Either way, I got really interested. I was like, oh wow, This article, then again, it's probably Halloween and they just release all these articles at this time of the year. Like, oh, this and that. They just pull shit out of their asses. Oh, man. All right, I guess before I even talk about that, so let's talk about Elon Musk buying Twitter. One of my buddies was asking me what was my opinion on it, and I didn't really have much of, like, an opinion on it. Like, I really don't give a fuck. I kind of hate Twitter. But I could see something happening here. Twitter, I hate Twitter. Now, Elon Musk might not be. We'll see what happens. But this might be a big changing point in reality. Because what has every piece of news reporting been for the past maybe 10 years? It's, if you put on the evening news, even like on like OTA, over the air, just like your regular TV shit. If you put on TV and you're watching the news, I would say 50%, maybe even more, are sourced. The source would be Twitter. I would say 50%, maybe 40% of all news on public TV is, all the stories are sourced via Twitter. Now, Elon Musk almost just completely just came in like a dinosaur or an asteroid and just made Twitter almost completely not mainstream anymore. Or maybe mainstream will change. We might be at a changing point of what is mainstream, which is slightly also slightly exciting, but also horrifying, because I'm sure they'll find a way to fuck it up. No matter, even if they do make it cool, if mainstream media becomes like, we're not just going to fucking, journalism's not dead. That's what, we need a renaissance of journalism. And every time we get it, it turns into like the fucking Vice or Wire Cutters, or it gets absorbed by the AP and it just turns to shit anyway. So there's... So basically what I'm trying to say is Elon Musk buying Twitter is not, the shit show must go on in one way or another. It's, they'll just start sourcing somebody new. Okay, this is what's going to happen. All the mainstream outlets are just going to find a new place to post. But they're going to need celebrities and stuff. And the celebrity, you know what? This is strange. It's a very strange thought pattern going down right now. You know, I need to listen to a voicemail. Because I need to get off this train before I get assassinated. I could see where I was going to go next with this conversation, leading me into never being able to go to another hot tub. And the sewer is basically like one giant hot tub. It's boiling water right there. I can just dip my feet in it. Let's do a voicemail. Also, if you want to give me a call at 917-719-5923, you can leave a voicemail right now. I will be opening the phone lines after I thank some people, which would be in like a segment or two. Just wait like 10 minutes, and if you want to talk to me, I don't know why you'd want to. You could. But the problem is that it'll be logged by Google. How much is, if Twitter was 44 billion, what is Google worth? What is the Google? Somebody in the chat, I'm sure somebody in the chat knows what, if you wanted to buy Google out right now, how much would that cost? Let's listen to a voicemail. 917-719-5923.
Hey, million dollars of cigarettes on Nicorette Radio. One of my college listeners just sent me a harmonica in the mail. Diane, you think I should try to play it? Okay, let's see what I can do. Oh, wow, that's fun. Wow, that's pretty good.
$1.1 trillion. $3 trillion?
I surprised myself. I hope you enjoyed it, listeners.
Elon Musk should buy Google. But until he could do that, he's got nothing. I guess Google. See, Google isn't even like part of the way people get information, but it is like it's. Not in your face, like they don't say, like on the news, like seen on Google, seen via Google search, this story about something. But to get to there, you need to use the Google. It's but then again, what are these fucking cable companies worth? What these? You'd think the people that provide the highway to the World Wide Web would be trillionaires, but. For some reason, I don't think, how much is Cox worth? Anybody, okay, chat, how much is, you know what I'm trying to say, like Cox or Spectrum, are they worth more than Google? Google's worth more, the information's worth more than the fucking, the cars are worth more than the road? I don't know.
Just wanted to call, see how you were doing. Remember, you just have to say fuck you and fuck you again. All right. Just wanted to, it's like 3:00 in the morning. And I'm running, old voice synthesizer. I'm blind runner, so. Man, I really want to talk. I want to sit down and talk with you. Just about quantum physics. It's crazy, man. So if you want to, let me know. All right, bud. I'll catch you later. All right, bye.
Do I want to talk to you about physics? The laws of physics? Yeah, why wouldn't I? I don't see why not. Give me a call at 917-719-5923. We could talk about the laws. 1.100... That's like tiddlywinks. 133 billion compared to 1.7 trillion? How many CEOs, how many people have access to this $1.17 trillion? Like, 1.8 billion? That's nothing. My poops are worth more than Capcom, I mean, Comcast and Spectrum. That's like the funny thing. People are always complaining like, oh, these wild millionaires out there. $1 million is it's a fly's fart compared to these numbers we're talking about here. These numbers right here, they make reality seem completely fucking stupid. Oh, the president of the United States gets $100,000 a year. Google's worth $1 trillion. Then again, I guess what's the deficit? Like $13 trillion? But then you know what? All I could say is it's definitely rain season. My umbilical cord. Thank some people. I was doing a wild rain stick dance. You heard nothing till now. Let's thank some people. Thank you, Harmonica Man. Thank you, No Agenda Network. Thank you, Sewer Chatters. Thank you, Brooklyn Brewery for letting me buy your alcohol. Thank you, Legal Gambling. We got a Powerball ticket here. What were the numbers? What's the Powerball number? Anybody got the Powerball numbers? Got a scratch-off ticket. Let's thank off the scratch-off ticket here. Oh, man, I'm gambling on live on Twitch. Kicked off here. The rain stick is not a very good way to scratch a scratchy. Let's see here. Got a knife, but... There you go, rat, nade bit, node bit. Node bit, what's going on, man? Let's see here. Oh, lost. Oh, what are those Powerball numbers, people? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7? It's $1 billion. 3, 7. I lost again. Ow, I almost stabbed myself. Come on. We're going to win big right on the air. That's what we want. We want degenerate gamblers to win it big while podcasting. Nothing there. What's the bonus? Did I get the boner? No. Don't gamble, kids. It's funny, like, you buy a Powerball ticket, and then when you're walking down the street, you're going to hear at least two or three people talking about, oh, boy, I don't even play, I don't even gamble, but the amount of money involved is just so big. I had a, what is it? It's $2 to play? You start hearing whispers in the street. Let's look at these Powerball numbers here. Let's do a live Powerball reading. Everybody wants that. This is legal, right? Can I do this? NewYorkLottery.gov. Powerball. There we go. What's the winnings? What are the winning numbers? How does this website work? This is so stupid. All winning numbers. Powerball. Filter by date. How do you get the date? How do you get the... I just want the last one. I just want the last Powerball. How does this work? Am I stupid? Wednesday, November 2nd. Maybe I don't know what I'm doing. Why are they letting? Let's thank some people. I did not get any. What are those called? Nothing in the P.O. box. No packages this week. You could go to nicktherat.com, click donate, and you could donate via PayPal. Let's see if I got any donations this week. PayPal. Oh, we got like three, I think, here. Whoa! $9.99. $9.99. From JF. JF with a 999. By the way, talking to Nicolas Cage last week was pretty amazing. Oof. Love that man. We have AM with $1 million. Why do I have to even play these Mega Millions if people are donating $1 million, man? Thank you so much, AM, for that donation. If you donate, I read your initials and... goodbye, PLLC. And I think that's it. Oh, wait, let's check Twitch. You can also give a Twitch donation, subscribe through there or something. Trey from Philly, that was seven days ago. Ducky, 7 days. Nothing. Nothing. Ugh.
Hey, man, I just wanted to play you some music, man.
What, Dieter? Sniffy, don't say nothing. We're on the fucking phone with the feds. I know it.
Anyways, man, I'm playing some music. Yeah, man, this is called Nick the Rat. Yeah, so, is a confused person, and he gets pissed off when you tell him. Get mad when I tell you you're selfish.
I didn't win the Powerball. You know how I found the Powerball numbers? I didn't go to the Powerball website. I used Google. I just typed in NY Powerball into the Google search, and it said tonight's Powerball numbers were. But I went to the New York Lottery... New York Gov suckmyballs.com, and I couldn't find the winning lottery numbers for that. It was too confusing. It was too confusing. boy, oh boy. You gotta love it. I really wanna fucking stay at your house, Wings of Ash. Water's good. You should always drink water. Like, during the show night, I drink a lot of beer, but rest of the days, I'm trying to chug as much water as possible. First, you know, like 8 cups, and then like 16 cups. You never know how much water they want to stick down your throat, but, you know, you're mostly water anyway, so it's good to drink it. You should always try to drink water. And the closer to death you become, the more aware of the amount of water you need. Anything can happen. You start to like look at your skin or your hands or your nails, or you get a weird bump on your anus or something. You have oozing pus filled, and then you start getting worried. Then you start thinking about if you're living your best life. You get a toothache. You go to the dentist. Dentist looks at you like, "What the hell you been doing?" Then you go to your doctor, and your doctor's like, "What are you doing?" And you always lie. You're not gonna fucking tell him the truth. Like, yeah, doctor, I basically don't move. Why would I? No point. Now you're like, yeah, you know, I play pro football. I'm on the tennis team. I go kayaking, climb mountains. But then one day, it's not the doctor that's going to make you drink water. It's when you look down at your butthole and you see oozing gobs of goo. The phone lines are open if you want to talk, by the way. 917-719-5923. You probably don't want to talk to me right now, though, because of what I just said. Understandable. Halloween, last week I reviewed Resident Evil Reavers. And I was very, very mad at it. It's a sucky game. It sucks. It's poo-poo. It's duty. It's garbage. But now last year was one of my favorite games, was Resident Evil Village. And also the year before that was probably Resident Evil Biohazard. I don't even know what they call it. Part 7 and 8. Those are like two amazing games. They put you in... in your little first-person mode view, you go around, creepy shit, shoot things. Loved it. Loved it so much. Caller, can you turn down your radio, please?
Yeah, I got you. I got you. Give me a second. Give me a second.
All right. How's that?
Caller, where are you calling from?
I am calling from the mini-apocalypse.
From a mini-apocalypse? Wow.
I know. You're telling me.
Caller, what's on your mind and what's in your pants?
What's in my pants is some pink underwear, and what's on my mind, speaking of pink, a friend of mine just went to go see Guar for the first time tonight.
Fuck yeah.
Very happy. Fuck yeah, dude. It always brings me joy knowing a friend just got slaughtered at a Guar show.
Do you know, it's weird now that I just was thinking about this, is Guar, the new Gallagher?
I mean, it's definitely it's lost its teeth over the years. I think there was a time where they were a truly fearsome band, not to be taken lightly. But I think just kind of over the years, the costumes have gotten so big, they've gotten so elaborate, it's lost a lot of that sort of raw, you know, like back in the day, it was like fucking Mad Max on stage. It was a lot of skin. It was a lot of sticky fake blood. It was a lot of leather.
Well, they were younger, yeah. But they should evolve. I think Guar needs to. Well, they evolved into bigger, elaborate costumes. But yeah, they.
Well, yeah. I think they have evolved, and I think they went kind of more in the comic book world, and you know that's nothing wrong with that.
No, I'm actually just happy that they still do their thing. That's fucking awesome. It's, and I'm jealous too. I would love to go to a Guar concert. Fuck yeah.
The have you been before?
No, I don't really go to many concerts. I'm not a. I don't like concerts.
Well, if it makes you, if this would entice you anymore, I'd go with you, and you could ride on my shoulder so you don't get squished in the mosh pit.
It gets very tight in there, and nobody cares if there's they'll step on me.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You can ride on my shoulder.
All right, let's do it.
Yeah, see, you just need it's a buddy system, man. Buddy system makes the world go round.
It's weird. I'm not a big concert goer. I did when I went to a my favorite concert was a Flaming Lips. I went to a Flaming Lips concert.
Okay.
But it was cool. It was cool because I was on drugs. But then the thing is, I don't really want to do drugs anymore. So I don't want to go to concerts because concerts aren't really that. Well, no, they're still fun. But drugs make them so much more fun.
I'm trying to think of it. I don't really do any shows where it's been more than two intoxicants at one time, mostly. Well, three, technically.
But, you know, I could just smoke some weed and enjoy the concert, too. But at Flaming Lips, I was on somebody gave me a piece of chocolate. They were like, eat this right now. Shut up and eat this. And I was like,
was it much?
It might have been. I was, woo.
Gone. Bye-bye. See you later.
I remember walking home with her, and I was tripping around. I must have looked like an insane person. I was doing like one of those walks that those fucking British people do. I was walking like a British.
Yeah, from the Ministry of Silly Walks.
Yeah. I was definitely doing a silly walk, but I was tripping balls. Whoa.
Yeah. Yeah, I like Tripping Balls. It's been a minute. It's been a while. Too much stuff going on.
I like it, but I also don't like it.
What do you not like about it?
That I like it?
Well, I don't know if I can help you in that regard.
Well, yeah.
Don't like it. Don't like it, Brett. You can't like this.
It also breaks down. I wouldn't be able to function very well. And I also do think it kind of leaves marks on you. And also, I don't want my previous memories to be underwater. Like, I smoked so much weed, I can't say, wow, that last time I smoked weed was really good. But I could be like, whoa, the last time I tripped was, wow, that was amazing. Because it was so long ago, and it was rare, which makes it more special.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would tend to agree. It's not something I have actively gone out, and more often than not, they've just kind of popped into my lap. And that's this seems the most appropriate way forward.
When it's a random encounter, like, wow, this is a group of new people. I'm with somebody that I know, and these people, I could trust them, I hope. Whee!
More like a rare encounter. Hey-o.
Well, yeah.
Rare encounters with weird old men.
Those are the best. I like weird encounters. I try to make encounters weirder. Weirder.
See, I got one rule. I got one rule and one rule only, and that rule is don't make it weird. And before you hang up on me, I'm going to explain to you what it means to not make it weird, because generally when people make stuff weird, it's just kind of like, meh. But as soon as don't make it weird, it automatically makes it weird. And then thus,
okay, I mean more like make it fun. It different. Because I understand what you're saying. Like, if I was just to come up to you and, like, not really know you, but, like, start smelling your arms or some shit, it's weird, but don't fucking do that. I mean, like, hey, I just met you. I might sound crazy, but what if I gave you something that was thick and hazy?
Yeah, or like you say that you want to come in for a kiss on my cheek, and then you lean in and turn my head and start sucking on my earlobe.
See, that's exactly what I'm saying that I do to you, because.
Well, I would suggest the right earlobe, because the left one, that one's been done too.
I'll kiss all three earlobes, especially since it's midnight in the sewer right now.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, it is. Happy midnight.
Oh, caller, do you play video games?
I really enjoy video games, but I find less and less time for them. I really
Do you like Resident Evil at all?
I really enjoy Resident Evil. I like the Resident Evil 1 remake on GameCube. I like Resident Evil 0.
Yeah.
I like Resident Evil 2.
Oh, 0 is enough.
You know, you're fucking 12 years old. Like, what do you know?
Well, no, I remember when it first came out, I was working at Blockbuster, and I was playing it in the bathroom on my GameCube that I had hooked up to a TV in there. And I was like, this is interesting. This looks cool. But then I didn't really play it after that. And then I played it recently, and that game, the controls are completely whack.
Yeah. Yeah, because you got to switch between Billy and Rebecca.
That's the cool part. No, trying to aim the gun, because you're not supposed to. You're supposed to save all your ammo for like one or two encounters. But to shoot something is incredibly hard, because you aim forward. These zombies, to hit them in the head, you have to aim up a little bit. So you have to like hit the you fucking jerk the gun up. And then there's the boss on that level is the spider, and you have to aim down, and it. And you're not shooting anything the entire fucking time until you get to the boss. It was stressful in a way that was more like I can't shoot something because the controls sucked. It was stressful because the controls sucked.
I remember Resident Evil 4 scared the tits out of me the first time I played that with...
4 was amazing. They're remaking that one.
Yeah. What number is this?
Well, 1 was amazing. 2 was amazing.
I just...
3 was... I don't... 4 was...
Never did.
Amazing. 5 was... 6 was...
Yeah. Never played 6.
7 and 8 I really loved. And then the DLC for 8, because Resident Evil switched over to the first person mode. And boy oh boy, it was very welcomed.
I want to try it. I want to try it. I haven't played 7 and 8 yet.
They're great. Do not get the DLC for fucking 8. I'm playing the DLC. I'm addicted to the first-person mode Resident Evil now. The DLC was third-person mode. And they touted it like a fucking... Oh, we made it third-person again. I was like, you fucks. I gave you 20 bucks.
Forward, 2 steps back.
So pissed. It's like I gave him 20 bucks to play third-person in the same fucking maps. Garbage, but it's decent, you know.
I think the last game that I played was the most recent Kirby that came out.
Ooh,
yeah.
That must have been fun.
Remember the name of it.
Was it like the yarn one? It wasn't the yarn one, was it? It was it was on the Switch, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and you turn into like 30 different things, or you turn into a whole bunch of stuff. And
Forgotten Land, Kirby in the Forgotten Land. They actually had this one power up. It was the final power up that you can unlock in the game, and it was cool because you had butterfly wings and a big like horny crown and a sword, and you could teleport using the butterfly wings. It was a lot of fun. Lots of replayability because you can just sit there and like do all the boss rushes over and over again. A lot of fun.
Whenever I play a Kirby game, I just think about how amazing his mouth is.
Yeah, I know.
And he's pink.
So pink.
Very pink.
I like Kirby. He's good people.
Yeah,
know?
Kirby is.
He's our guy. Yeah.
He's good in Smash Brothers too. He's not a bad character.
No. I could get down with some Smash Bros. I like that.
You probably use Kirby too, don't you? You cheap son of a bitch.
I'm actually a Link guy.
Old Link or young Link?
I think young Link's pretty fun. I like...
He throws the bombs, right? I like the one that threw the bombs. Uh-oh!
Yeah.
Caller, they're coming for you! Caller? Oh, shit. Her Brain is a Jungle by Roxy Lau. Thank you. So I guess what I'm trying to say is the Resident Evil DLC is worth maybe $10. It brings you back through the fucking same maps, a little bit of different powers, a little bit new story. But it's third person. Whoa. It's disgusting. The worst podcast ever. Going around burping in your ear. Let's break up some more weed here. What was we be talking about? Oh yeah, there was this we're talking about talking to the dead. The phone line's open. Diana, is the phone line working? I can't see, the weed is in the way.
Hey, Nick the Rat, it's still Wire.
Hey.
I listened to the last couple episodes I was on, and I kept saying I was going to tell you a ghost story, and we never got to it. And so,
really?
Here now, it is 10:34 Mountain Time on Halloween. I am finally going to tell you the ghost story that I never got to. But first, I gotta take a whiz, so after I hang up, go ahead and play some music and, you know, play some ads, you know, you gotta pay your bills. And I'll get back to you with a good story.
He's got a point. Play some advertisements, because we got some bills to pay.
Oh, hey, kids. This is your friend, Grimbo the Grumpy. Grimbo the Grumpy. I just want to let you know that I used to be really fucking grumpy. I used to spit when I'd see people on the street. I'd be walking down the street. Somebody, they'd look at me. They'd look at me. They'd call me a Muppet or something. I'd say, Muppet, I seen you on TV. I'd spit. I'd hock a loogie. I'd get deep guttural. I'd pull it out deep from the back of my throat, and I'd spit right in the face. I knew I had some issues, you know. Gimbo the Grump has got issues sometimes, but I went to seek professional help from a mental health facility, and they prescribed me a new drug. They even named it after me. They were like, hey, Gimbo the Grump, you're so popular on TV, you could help millions of little 5-year-old kids that, you know, they're annoying. They won't shut up. You know, they're always asking questions like, come on, relax. You're 5 years. You don't need to know everything. Here, take some of these new dark sewer Gimbo the Grumps gummies. They're for grumps. They're really good. They're I think they got fentanyl in them. Don't worry. We're gonna solve a lot of. I feel like I'm a little sleepy. Gimbo the Grumps. I gotta go, kids. I gotta shoot. I gotta do another episode for the little kids out there. We're gonna teach them about the letter C. I'm gonna tell them it's for cunts. G is where it's at. Anyways, Gimbo the Grump, coming to you from the dark sewer network, kids. And go get your gummies.
Well, we here at Carve Our Us will carve the fuck out of pumpkin for you. Yeehaw! And don't forget us when November comes. We also do turkeys for Thanksgiving, and we can get rid of your Christmas trees for you, too. What do we do the rest of the year, you ask? Circumcisions. Yeehaw! Call us now, 917-719-5923.
This is a local myth told in Spearfish in so many ways that it's hard to pin down what the true story is, if there really is one. That's why I haven't told this story yet. Specific details vary but the heart of the tale is always the same. I'll try to tell this story the best that I can, even if there are no facts and only myths. It centers around a boy. Sometimes he's like 7, sometimes he's like 12, sometimes he's somewhere in between. Again, I can't pin down any facts because it's always told differently. Can't believe I'm doing this. All right, here I go. So, the story centers around this boy, his favorite mountain bike, and the spearfish bike path. Everything else is hearsay. Sometime around the early 60s to the mid 80s. Again, it's a wide window. I don't know. I've always heard it different. But anyway, so in that time, there was a boy named either Drew, Carl, Chad, Ivan, Ian, Steve, whatever. But anyway, whatever his name was, he ran away from home on his favorite mountain bike after a fight. Some say it was his mom and dad on the brink of divorce. Some say it was a curse thrust upon him by his older brother. Yet some say it didn't have anything to do with his fam at all, but from bullies from school that came to torment him in the night. Whatever the reason, the boy ran away from home on his favorite bike on what was normally his favorite night, Halloween. However, Unlike these autumn years, he was faced with cold and severe winds and no clear path. He died peacefully up in the hills.
All right. There we go. Sorry. It's going to flood out someplace somewhere. Sorry, whoever gets flooded out. What were we talking about tonight? Oh, yeah, there's some company that said that they made technology to talk to the dead. I was thinking that this was, they say they record your loved ones. And I was like, wow, they're using AI to take people's voices and to be able to put them into any sort of structure. Kind of like, you know that website, the Jordan Peterson website? It doesn't work anymore. They took it off. I think Jordan Peterson sent lawyers after them. Not Jordan Peterson.com. Not Jordan Peterson. Not Jordan. There's an alternative. Not Jordan Peterson speech alternative. So there's a website called NotPeterJordanson.com. Not Jordanson Peter. What is his name? Not Jordan Peterson. And the functionality of the site is currently disabled. They disabled it. Are they trying to say Jordan Peterson is disabled or the site is? I don't know.
Hello and welcome to NotJordanPeterson.com. This is not Jordan Peterson. In fact, I'm a neural network designed to sound like Dr. Peterson. Unfortunately, for the time being, the site will remain inoperable, but please sign up to the mailing list below if you would like to stay informed of future developments.
I'm surprised they're even allowed to have that up. But what they did is they took his speech patterns, his words, and they made a fucking bot out of him. And it sounds like Jordan Peterson. So that's what I thought that this website did. I thought this website would have like a list of words. All right, if you're going to train an AI to sound like you, it's gonna work maybe for like podcasters. Mine's going to have a constant drip in the background. But it makes sense because I'm drinking and I'm always congested. So also the drip's only at like 40% volume. It's very low. But if you listen, it's there. Because we mic up the drains in the sewer, but my voice is slightly tainted by these drops. Probably filter them out somehow. So I thought this website would take your voice and make a bot, an AI out of it, like a Siri. It's like that Siri lady. That's a lady. She recorded all those words. She sounds like a bot. But she recorded every word in existence. And that's the problem with these. The upgrades in graphical artificial intelligence, it's not really intelligent. It's mathematical. It's correct. We had power to do this using computers for a long time, like 3D programs could it does physics, basic physics, like Isaac Newton physics. What is that, Newtonian? We've had computers that could replicate Newtonian physics since Doom, I guess. But now we're getting computers that can do physics of like waveforms and things that are more sudden than things that are more slow. There's things you hear and things you see. Computers are good at things you hear and you see. That's about it. Two out of the six senses. computers can't do taste or smell, or what's that last? What's there's sight, sound, taste, smell, sweet, sour. Wait, hold on. Is there only four senses? How many senses are there? Wow. Hold on 1 second here. Touch, sight, hearing, smell, and taste. All right, well, computers suck at touch, smell, and taste, but they're really good at sight and hearing. So I thought this AI would take your vocal waveforms and be able to create like a bot that talks. Boy, oh boy, I was wrong. Anyway, let's listen to a song really quick. We'll be back, and I'll tell you why I was wrong and what it really is. But my idea is pretty cool. Like, if you could, like, didn't James Earl Jones, they just use his voice now? Like, he licensed his voice to be used for Vader, so he doesn't have to show up at the studio. He did his lines already. I don't know. Maybe I'm just a dreamer. Or dreamers. Am media.
The world is such a different place these days. But I think too much. I'm just trying to get out of my mind at this point.
The number you have dialed is not available at present. Please leave your message after the beep.
Hey, it's me. we'll just keep reaching for the moon. But for now, I'm here. I like this groovy cycle, baby. Whole beat electric.
Tell me exactly how to engineer the situation I'm in.
I'll tell you exactly how. You got a big voice. Have the balls as a man to call out the individuals. Don't call them Jews. Call them by their name.
I would defend to the death his right to do everything he does. The thing that I find unusual, and it's, you know, it's not a criticism so much, but his targets are underdogs. And comedy traditionally has picked on people in power. People who abuse their power. Women and gays and immigrants are kind of, to my way of thinking, underdogs. And, you know, he ought to be careful because he's Jewish. And a lot of the people who want to pick on these kind of groups, the Jews are on that list a little further. You got women, gays, gypsies, blah, 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 blah. And then suddenly you find Jews. And Andrew,
suddenly Andrew's arrested.
Yeah. So, you know, I mean, obviously he should do what he wants. And
why does he get away with it, do you think, then?
Well,
we have never laughed at jokes about the
Well,
poor.
He's appealing. I think he's appealing largely. I think his core audience are young white males who are threatened by these groups. I think a lot of these guys aren't sure of their manhood because that's a problem when you're going in through adolescence. You know, am I really? Am I? Could I be? I hope I'm not one of them. And the women who assert themselves and are competent are a threat to these men, and so are immigrants in terms of jobs and the
so that's why we as an audience then will laugh.
You say we. I don't think you're
I mean,
in there,
I don't know.
But
I mean,
think you're
collective
that,
we.
I think that's what is at the core of that experience that takes place in these arenas. Is a certain, a sharing of anger and rage at these targets. And I'm sure Andrew isn't that angry at them. I'm sure he's playing it as a comic.
People tell me, well, you were so mean to Ellen Page. And I think, well, you know, Ellen Page is a star and she advertised her transformation and made the claim that this has revolutionized her life. And then she displayed her new body in a public forum and got 1.7 million Instagram likes for it and probably enticed, well, let's say one young girl who's confused into becoming sterile, which is one too many for me, but it could be as many as what, 100, 500, 1,000? And I have my tendency to feel a hell of a lot more sorry for a set of confused, isolated, and lonely pubescent girls who have no one to love them enough to help them appreciate who they are than I do for one overprivileged and unfortunately confused narcissistic Hollywood star.
What's up with that? What's up with Jordan Peterson? He always cries when he's always crying. He's such a strong man. Thanks. The dude's gonna take a little example from him. I'm gonna release my feelings too. Oh God. I just want my job back, Nick.
We in America are misinformed. Reality shows have warped our idea of what a hero is or what the truth is. So tonight, I'd like to dedicate this award to those who remind us of our virtues, who remind us of the truth. To Sir Charles Chaplin, who battled McCarthyism into exile. To Christopher Steele, who tried to pull a thorn out of the paw of an ungrateful beast. To Christine Blasey Ford, to Colin Kaepernick. He'll stand for the anthem when the anthem stands for him. And to one of my friends, my good friends, and one of the greatest artists of our time, Robert De Niro, whose life was threatened also this week, along with many other incredibly decent people who bring joy to the world, who've been dedicated to it for years, for decades. How dare they besmirch those people?
Oh, shut the fuck up, Jim Carrey. What the fuck do you know? You're just in that. You just said that we're brainwashed by fucking entertainers. Have you looked in the mirror? You fucking hypocrite.
The future information economy, what's going to make it possible for people to create intellectual products and still get paid for them when there are no more deep bits and information is a free-floating field?
My thoughts about that were probably so weird and utopian that they're going to be cliches in 10 years and everybody will accept them. But right now they're going to sound pretty far out. I think currency is going to disappear because in the first place, currency is not coin. Most people never realize from the time we invented paper money, we were out of the mystique of the precious metals. Paper money is whatever the group in power says it is. There's no difference between a dollar printed by the Federal Reserve Bank and a dollar printed by a gang of counterfeiters, except that the Federal Reserve Bank has a patent from the government. Otherwise, there's no difference. The one made by the counterfeiters could be worth more than the one made by the Federal Reserve if Andy Warhol hung it in a museum as found art. And the whole currency mystique is based on very deep hypnosis. I think we are coming out of that hypnosis because nobody in no country in the world can pay their national debt anymore. The acceleration factor, knowledge doubling faster and faster, producing more and more technology, doing more and more with less and less, means that unemployment is going to increase by quantum jumps. And it's not just Reagan who says we can't give more to the people on welfare. You find that all over Europe they're saying the same thing. And as a matter of fact, they're not being anal retentive. The thing is, governments can't borrow any more money. They're in debt up to their eyeballs, and they can't borrow anymore. All the banks can do is loan them more to pay the interest on what they've already borrowed. And eventually, we are going to have to replace currency with something else. I have suggested an international currency because in Europe, there's a lot of talk about a European currency. And so I think the world is about ready. If they're talking about a European currency, the next step is to talk about an international currency that could be issued by the United Nations. But I regard that as a stopgap measure for slow learners while the human race adjusts to the radical new situation we're in. Eventually, we abolish currency entirely. And how will people get rewarded for their work? There will be so much new wealth unleashed once we get out of the hypnosis of the old industrial system and start retuning the planet according to the ideas of futurist thinkers like Bucky Fuller and Barbara Montsubbert and so on, many others who thought along those lines. The reward of your work will be fame and the satisfaction of seeing the world change the way you want it to change because the new thing you created is really popular with everybody and they're all using it. And if you think you need something beyond that, you don't understand the revolution that's occurring because everybody will have more than enough of everything. We are, to borrow a metaphor from the engineer Charles Douglas, we are in the position of people in the middle of a blizzard fighting over snowballs. We're just not aware of the blizzard of new wealth that's raining down on us. Wealth is ideas that work. And ideas that work are multiplying faster than ever. That's what the whole technological revolution is. More and more ideas that work are being discovered every hour on the hour. for instance, 99.99975% of all the available energy on this planet is not being used yet. That's what was the fullest calculation in the world game computers in Philadelphia. When we start using some of that energy, the wealth of the human race will increase fantastically. Right now, people on welfare are living better than the kings lived in the 13th century. The wealthy class of today is living 100 times better than John D. Rockefeller lived at the end of the 19th century. Wealth is accumulating exponentially all the time.
Okay, so what happened here yesterday?
I understand it happened.
Basically, me and my friend Stephanie, we needed some money. We saw a girl selling Girl Scout cookies. We saw an envelope with money in it, and I grabbed it, and she drove away.
Why did you do it?
Because we needed money. We just wanted money.
What did you need the money for?
Just for anything. We didn't have any money. And it was just the easy way of getting money.
But you do realize, I mean, you're going to be charged with a crime.
Oh, I was already charged with the crime and actually pissed because I should have kept that money if they charged me with all the charges I just got.
But does it worry you? I mean, that you would committed a misdemeanor?
Well, nothing's... I mean, there's nothing I can do about it now, but...
What about the people who would say, all right, you know, it's one thing to steal money, it's another thing to do it from a 9-year-old girl selling Girl Scout cookies?
I mean, money's money. I mean, I feel bad it was a 9-year-old girl, but there was $150 in that envelope, and I wanted that money, and it was mine.
How dare you!
I just want to say that I'm sorry for offending the Girl Scout organization, but other than that, that's it.
I mean, some people might say it's... I heard one person in our newsroom call it heartless to steal money from a 9-year-old girl. I mean,
it's not her money. A 9-year-old girl was selling it, but it's not like she was going to make that money. So it doesn't really bother me. The only thing that bothers me is my charges now.
What was the other crime that you had been charged with?
Domestic battery.
And, you know, if you say this or step out of line, we're going to fine you. There's this idea that you're going to have to create a parallel economy in order to function, essentially. So don't give your money to, I mean, I think the Daily Wire did it with the razors. They had like Harry's razors. Yeah, they did. And Jeremy did some razors. So it's like, oh, don't give your money to people who hate you. Give your money to people who share your ideology. But then you have these, you know, the silos are forming where it's like, then everyone's over here and everyone who agrees is over here and no one's forced to actually articulate their ideas or disagree with one another. It's just everyone like smelling their own farts.
Pretty much, we just saw the Girl Scouts with their little table, and me and my friend were like, let's get that money that's in that envelope. Because it was just sitting on the table, and it was her and her mom, and her mom wasn't really paying attention. She was yapping to some lady, and the girl was just standing there by herself. And so my friend goes into Winn-Dixie. I was waiting outside of here, like ready to leave. So she grabs the envelope, she snatched it really quick, she ran to my car, and we left, and we parked, and we split the money.
Why did you do it?
I mean, who doesn't like money? I mean, I don't know.
What the fuck, Kanye? What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? Why do you do what you do? Really? DEFCON 3, Kanye 3, 3? Which one is that? Is that the worst one? That's which one is the third?
Increase in force readiness above normal readiness. Yeah, may not pose immediate danger, but warrant significant alert.
Is that threatening?
I don't fucking know.
Is that? I don't know. We make shoes here. I don't know about no motherfucking DEFCON 3 or nothing like that. But that don't sound like
It sounds like defense, don't it? You know, but still, motherfucker, the Jews.
But it's a crime.
I know it's a crime, but it was an easy crime. It was easy. It was sitting right there. I mean, there is a lesson learned now, but I didn't think I was going to get caught for it like that. I wasn't really aware of the cameras or anything. I didn't think about it. Didn't really think.
What's the lesson you say that you could learn out of this?
Probably not to get caught, or maybe not to steal.
I mean, do you have any remorse about stealing from a 9-year-old girl?
Right now, no.
Very deeply inflammatory tweet, which I think you've now accepted. You shouldn't have phrased that way. It's taken a bit of time to get there, but I think you have accepted that, right?
Have you accepted that you've put no effort into understanding how I got there?
Honestly,
10 years from now,
honestly, I don't think there is
gonna
any.
You're going to apologize to me about this interview.
I'm not.
You're going to apologize to me about this interview within the next 10 years.
No, I'm not. Because here's the thing.
Mark my words.
I don't doubt you've had.
It's very one-sided.
No, it's not.
It's very white-sided.
Oh, come
it's
on.
It's very one-sided. Don't. It's very like.
It's not white-sided. I'm not doubting you've had business issues. I'm saying the way to respond to that is
you
not to go public
me.
To millions
no,
of people
you
and say you're going DEFCON 3 on Jewish
no,
people.
Millions of people. Right. Millions of people have had DEFCON 3 on their contracts.
Right.
Millions of people. Well, I opened it up. Now I'm saying it now. Sir.
Okay. So now what now I think you should say, I think you should say to the Jewish people, I'm sorry for the offensive language I used in that tweet. I wouldn't do that again. This is what I really meant. I think people would respect you if you said that. I don't know why you can't just say that.
When I'll say it? When I sit down with the people who write out the contracts for the NBA and for the NFL and for professional music and for acting contracts. We need to go to the top lawyers, the top execs, the owners of the stadiums, the owners of the football teams, and the owners of the record labels. And we're going to put them all in one room. And we're going to read let's go top 10 in each one of these categories, right? Let's read Michael B. Jordan's contract.
Okay, but why would any of that?
I ain't finished. I ain't finished my sentence.
Nothing you're saying has anything to do with regret.
Don't finish. I told you. Don't treat me like a boy then.
I'm
going to finish my sentence and my idea.
Nothing you're saying has got anything to
do
with the tweet.
Cool. I was in the middle of a sentence, boy. Okay, so are you going to allow me to finish my sentence?
Yes. If you then answer my question.
Okay, so I'm going to tell people when I would apologize for the tweet. This is what has to happen first. I need all of the top executives in Hollywood. I need the top executives at the NBA and at the NFL. We'll do those two sports specifically. And I want the top executives in music, dealing with publishing, dealing with like Spotify and Apple Music and Universal Music and all the top exec, let's do like 5 top execs there. And I want to look at the top 10 earners in each one of those fields contracts openly. We want to compare and contrast the contracts. And then once we open that conversation, and we need to do it on a platform live with lawyers asking questions, and we'll have the top lawyers like a Johnny Cochran, Robert Kardashian level legal team, you know, looking at all of these contracts together. After that moment happens, then I will say, I'm sorry.
Oh boy, Kanye. Kanye West, he's a black man, right? I don't know, I'm an alien from Oktar, so I don't really know anything about color of skin or anything. You all taste the same. Just like fucking, tastes like crickets. Yeah, that's what you guys taste like. Yeah, it sounds like Kanye's a black man, and he's doing from what I see as an outsider from all this planet, Kanye is doing yay is doing to the Jews with the rest of the country right now is doing to, wait, what's that other species on Earth that tastes like cricket? The white man. Yeah, the white man. Basically, anybody could shit on the white man, right? And that's what Ye is doing. Ye is a weird specimen, but his question will bring to light, you think about it. Think about all the celebrities, all the athletes, all the, there's like only a couple people at the top of this pyramid. If we brought, I'm down, but I think we should broaden the spectrum and get all the tops, the pyramid. I want to see everybody that's controlling everybody's everything, especially their naked pictures.
Child stealing from a 9-year-old girl?
Right now, no, because I'm kind of pissed because I have charges and we need to give the money back anyway, so now I'm pretty pissed.
But I mean, some people might say it's, you know, not the nicest thing to do to steal money from a child, especially a Girl Scout selling cookies.
Well, I don't know. Money's money, and it doesn't really matter to me. I don't feel sadness for that little girl. I mean, she's getting a lot of money right now from people who feel bad for her, so whatever.
What were you going to use the money for?
Probably for gas. Just for gas money and, like, my cigarettes and stuff. I don't know.
Are you worried about the misdemeanor charges?
Yes, I'm very worried. I'm worried that they might come back up a month later and I'm going to have cops knocking on my door for a warrant. So those people over there, I'm very pissed.
Okay. Anything else you want to say? Or?
Not really.
I don't have every intention of holding on to the House and the Senate. That is, and they are good at what they do, and you should respect the fact that they are able to get away with this. They got away with it with Gore when he won. We didn't do anything about it. They got away with when Hillary won. We don't do anything about it. They know us.
Yeah.
They know we're busy and we got other things to do. But they are fanatical about this because they know their time is up. And the sort of the angry white guy, which actually I'm really Trump's demographic. Cause
yeah.
I'm
Michigan angry white guy.
I'm an
guy,
angry
yeah.
white guy over 50 with a high school education. So that's me.
Yeah.
So if I could just speak to my fellow angry white American guys who are semi-uneducated like me. Dudes, give it up. We've been running the show for 10,000 years. It's like we've had a long run as men running everything. And you know, the Yankees could never win as many pennants as we've won in these 10,000 years as
right.
men. So why don't we just take a break? Let the majority gender run the show.
Just for, yeah. Just to see how it would go.
What are you scared of? Women actually like us, most of us. You know, so I just think there's just this.
No, you said you had to give the money back. Did you spend any of it before?
Oh, I spent $50 on gas. I filled up my gas tank, and that's it. But I was planning on buying, like, a necklace and all this stuff and a new phone. But now I guess not. We should have at least got to keep the money. Am I allowed to answer the phone?
The Jews, the motherfucker that signed everybody checks in the universe, Kanye! Nobody cares if you talk down on your own people or Mexicans, because we know the only power that Mexicans hold is a power drill. But under no circumstances ever should you ever talk about Jews or the LGBTQ, because that is literally worse than talking down on God. I didn't say anything wrong.
Rub mustard on my what?
Then I will say I'm sorry.
Okay, if that's your position, that's
clear. Interview adjourned. Love you.
Hello?
I just took the most relaxing urination piss. I took a really good pee break. But how do you say that without saying taking a piss break? I relieved myself. You just say I went to the bathroom, right? I took number one. Is number one the way to go? So I was thinking this technology was going to be really cool. Like, whoa, blown away. There's a fucking, an app that will record some voice, like. Record like 80 hours of voice, which would take a fucking long time, be annoying to do. But over your lifespan, you could do. And then you could make like a Siri out of it. That'd be like a Ouija board. Be like, hey, name anybody that has 80 hours of their voice recorded. What's the weather today? You could have like your dead. Dead podcaster. Your best. Your your best audio experience, people pumped back into your ears and talk to you. It's kind of like the AI that they're doing with like artwork. Because these artworks, they're just stealing. They're stealing, it's basically computers stealing and reprocessing stolen art. Using like keywords and math. It's all just math. It's all fucking Newtonian with a little bit of triggers on and off. Yeah, hey, is it this? Is it that? What is this and what is that? Over 10 years, you could train something trainable. You could train something that never existed before how to exist. In 20 years, we're almost there. Especially something that is already a complete slave to us. Computers and electrons are like humanity's bitch. But all of humanity, not just like the rich, not the poor, everybody. Like fire is power too. And cavemen, they discovered how to capture fire. And since then, energy has been a dying meat's tool, a slave. Well, no, that's not what this fucking app is anyway. Let's take a voicemail. 917-719-5923.
This song is called I Love You, Beth Lee. And Beth Lee, if you're listening right now, I'm not sorry it didn't work out. Because I would have never questioned if I knew what love or what God was. I would have just been fooled by our relationship. And Diane, if you're listening to this, you know, Nick doesn't know what love is, because love implies the highest intelligence, the highest sensitivity to the moment. It basically means you understand life and you know what love is. Something that can happen to you. Anyway, Diane, you might want to break up with Nick so he can run off and make sure he finds out what love is. Even that probably won't be a catalyst for understanding, but anyhow...
Enjoy the rain, people. I don't know. Diana, is the phone lines open? By the way, caller, Diane can't leave. I'm using duct tape. And boy, is Diana quacker. I think there's like a magical symbol on the bottom of my What is that? Is that Patrick Starr? Do you want to hear this bullshit? Wait, hold on one sec. Actually, thank you to all the people that make music that I play on the show. Thank you. This is all CC BY 3.0. 100% free. You could use it in any way you want. But also, you could use this show in any way you want. If you want to reuse anything you hear during the show, people playing harmonicas or burping, go for it. I'm trying to get online for the digital reincarnation. I would like to be made into an. If maybe I should stop recording with the that pipe over there. It keeps dripping, but that does clean up all the piss. And then it runs down here. And if I want to do that, I have to build a wall. Can I build a wall? No, fuck. That pipe is good. And if I build a wall, I have to cut a hole in the wall. And that's going to let the sound in anyway. Because I need that river. You need the flow of water. You know what? Just have the pipe with me. When I'm long dead and gone, I give everybody the right to create the website. Not nicktherat.com. Maybe I should get that website and the technology they used for the Jordan Peterson one. And then I could have an AI go scrub all the footage. I'll record myself. I'm just going to start doing green screen with no background. So in the future, I could exist. Everybody that's charging for their likeness won't exist in the future. They're going to disappear in some corporate bullshit orgy. Getting lost in the mix. Money's weird. I don't know.
Yet his spirit was unresolved. He died because he had no clear path to guide him to safety. Over the years since then, Spearfish has built bike paths first through city parks, and then they connected those back bike paths to the city parks. And these are great city parks, too. Great city parks, but the bike paths themselves are even better because they're wide enough that two really wide mountain bikes can pass each other without having to swerve real hard. It's great. But anyway, I digress. But anyway, locals of all ages have caught glimpses and whispers of the spectral boy loving every second of riding his bike on the pike path. But it doesn't stop there. There are so many unofficial bike paths in and around Spearfish and Tinton Road that even if you loved wandering here in 100 years, you'd still never know them all. Oh, I wrote that like a drunkard.
The facts of life. The facts of life. Do 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 do. Wait, hold on. I gotta do some math here. Hold on 1 second. My math has changed. What is? I didn't open this up. Skip that. Get out of here, you. Scoot. Skedaddle. Scoot. Okay. I could talk about this. Here we go. Okay. Henry Cavill will not be in The Witcher season 4 because the production company started fucking up in season 2 and was not upholding the mythos of The Witcher. God bless Henry Cavill. Cheers to you, my Warhammer PC gaming nerd. Who has a soul, and I don't think his soul's going away. Is Henry, I don't care if he's single or not, but if he is, Diane, we might have to, I might have to, I'm going to put Henry on my lacquered if 3 came here. Oh, man. Talking about friends. Matthew Perry released a book. And it's just craziness. And pretty much every part of the book is just free to read on the internet because each chapter is just like a story of him getting fucked up. I think, judging by all the news that I've read, and it, daily there's Matthew Perry. He's like, but the thing is, if you're doing drugs, it's kind of like it's like gonzo journalism. You can't trust the teller of the stories. He was on drugs. He said he went to people's parties to steal their drugs. Matthew Perry was probably very rich for a large portion of his life. Even if he owned a house in Manhattan, he'd still have enough money to buy drugs and not have to steal them from people. And then there's stories about how many times he went to fucking rehab and all this stuff. And then he dissed Keanu Reeves. He was like, why is Keanu Reeves still alive and this person's dead? Why do I know all this? It was probably on Twitter. If it's not Twitter, it's some other gigantic megalo corporation. And I guess Elon Musk saw that the Twitter was the low-hanging fruit for all the lulls and the jokes. He could have probably bought a lot of different services. But Twitter's the hot one, and it's cheap. It's like a hot, cheap fucking...
Calling to warn you about them rays. Them cosmic rays. They're high energy. Not unlike myself. They travel nearly at the speed of light. I think they like to hang back. See what happens to the light in front of them. See what they're gonna take the same path as light. I'm like, no, go ahead, light. We'll catch up later. They hang back, see what happens to the light, and they take their own path.
What he said. But, also, I do have a personal Matthew Perry story that happened.
Get here.
Caller.
They hit our atmosphere, they break up those rays, cosmic rays, they jizz all over.
I do think I was in 50 feet of him, maybe 50 yards.
So, cosmic rays, like 50 feet. Jizzing all over everybody. How you feel? You got, you got cosmic rays just all over your body.
I think like 10, 15 years ago, maybe 20, 25. I was on crossing over Houston Street and Canal to get to the Q train. And I saw Matthew Perry And I think I said, "What's up, Chandler Bing?" I actually probably did say something dumb like that. And I do recall him looking at me as I was crossing the street to get to the train. This also happened with Bill Nye, the science guy. I saw the Bill Nye coming out of the where is that? 14th Street. Not Union Square Station. He's coming up the stairs with this I think she's like a young, she might have been Cantonese. There was a young lady with her. And I was like, "Oh, Bill Nye." This is before I disliked him more. I always liked Beekman's World more than Chandler Bing, but I didn't dislike the guy. But once you become like involved with the government or gigantic, once you get a following and you get a microscope on you, you gotta be cool. You gotta be cooler. Yeah, it'd be cooler than Stranger Things. And luckily, we have cyberpunkers to get us there.
Okay, boys, this one's called Day One Without Weed Blues. Hit it, boys. I fucking hate life.
So life and computers and math and all that and physics. There was a NASCAR racer dude. I think it was NASCAR. I'm not too sure what kind of racer he was. It looked like a regular car. He said he used the trick from a 2005 GameCube game. And I was like, I had to watch this. And I was like watching what it was. And he runs his car into the wall of his race, of the racetrack. And he uses that for physics to kind of throw him forward. Now, I don't think this would really work properly. I think he did floor it. So he's probably hitting it as fast as he could. And he was letting the wall turn his fucking car. Horrifying. If anything was on the wall to hit it, it would throw him off. But apparently it worked this time. He said he learned the tactic from a 2005 GameCube game. Now, this is, it exists. It's real. I'm just going to play the interview. I'm going to start the interview. It's,
Ross.
Hold on. Let me open it over here.
Ross Chastain. Oh, my word.
Ross Chastain. C-H-A-S-T-A-I-N. I think he went from, he got like five places.
How did you ever dream up a scenario where something like that would be what you needed to do and that it would work?
Oh, played a lot of NASCAR 2005 on the GameCube with Chad growing up, and you could get away with it. And I never knew if it would actually work. And I did that when I was 8 years old, and I grabbed fifth gear. I asked off at two on the last lap if we needed it, and we did. I couldn't tell who was leading, and I just made the choice. I grabbed fifth gear down the back and full committed. Once I got against the wall, I basically let go of the wheel. Just hope I didn't catch the turn four access gate or something crazy, but I was willing to do it. And for this track house group, right, we've done everything. We did so much right this year that for Advent Health, the Moose Jockey, Worldwide Express, to lose Rob this year,
his post-speech is starting to make me think that it's fake. It's like you did something crazy, and then you start to, I guess you got to bring up the you got to talk about politics. Darn politics. Okay, look, people. We were talking about this app that brings back people from the dead. Let's listen to their advertisement of it. I think you'll learn everything you need to know from it. It's garbage. Wait, I said it was garbage. You have to hear it first. Where technology that lets us speak to our dead relatives has arrived. Basically, it's LiveJournal. Basically, it's like learn how to record yourself. Basically, it's say you wanted to talk to a dead relative. How would you do it? You should do it. You should make your own podcast. Okay. This is an interesting thought here. You should probably record yourself talking to future generations of people you know. If you're not going to procreate or propagate, you might still want to do this. Do you know anybody? Now, does that anybody you know anybody else? Well, then why not let those people know what you're thinking? If you're not willing to share your thoughts with people that you know, then what are you doing? What are you doing? Seriously, what are you doing? So you could make recordings and be like, if I ever go listen to these, like, I want you to know this. That's basically what this service is. It's like a life journal of like a bucket list of what you should have told your friends or family. It's a really, I thought AI and your voice, they could probably make you tell you stories. I'm not going to tell you what I thought yet, but let's listen to their spiel. Is Ye okay with me saying it's their spiel? Where's their advertisement? Here we go. There's the links right here. Hereafter AI. This is not AI. This is a fucking server. This is a hard drive Here, listen to the fucking ad. I'm fucking mad.
What if there was one place where all of your memories could live forever? One place where you could ask any question about the life of someone you love and always hear their voice. Introducing Hereafter AI, the amazing new way to save and share memories about your life. First, you record memories with the help of a friendly automated interviewer.
Hi, I'm James. What would you like to do?
So they give you, they interview with a bot.
What's something unusual about your childhood?
And when I was growing up, my dad was a preacher, and we moved around a great deal.
Got it. I'll save that memory.
Pick the topic yourself or get an inspiring suggestion. You can also upload photos to go with your stories.
Yes. It's
then,
it's
using the power of our AI
this
platform,
so
your loved ones can chat with the virtual you today or years in the future. Unlike conventional methods for storing memories, Hereafter is interactive.
Hey, Grandpa.
Hello. What part of my life would you like to hear about now?
Tell me something that I don't know about you.
Sure. One time I played basketball against the Harlem Globetrotters, and I scored a three-pointer.
That's crazy.
I guess that is kind of a strange story when you think about it.
Tell me something else surprising about you.
There was a time that I was the pilot of a competition biplane
and
did barrel...
This bullshit? Okay, look. It's basically... There's an AI that has a set of questions that it asks you. And then you record it. And then... your sad future generation... If I'm ever like my grandfather has a Hereafter AI and I get force-fed questions to ask it for you to tell it to me, first I'm going to think, how much of a loser were you? And how much of a loser am I for using this service? If you want your relatives to... Oh, God. Okay, let's just keep playing. It's fucking... This pissed me off. There's like a whole Scientific America fucking... Talk to the dead with AI. No, it's not. It's fucking pre-recorded answers to questions that were pre-recorded. Boop.
Rolls and loops.
Your voice, your personality and stories, your forever. Try
no,
for free or get
test.
A gift membership for someone you love.
Hello, everybody. I'm a dark sewer scientist. Usually they don't let us talk on the air that much, but I would just like to let you know that Nick the Rat's done a lot of great for us this year. He's given us new technology we could only dream of. The things that are going to be coming out of the sewer next year are going to scare the pants off you. Let me tell you something. I've seen women with six legs and men with four heads. When you watch them have sex, it looks like a... looks like a octopus sumo wrestling mud bath. I don't know, it's gross. But I'm to let you know that 2019 is going to be a big year in the sewer. And if you'd like to chip in, go on down to nicktherat.com, click on the donate button, and give them all your money through PayPal. You could either subscribe for $4.20 a month and let them know that you love them, or you could give them any type of money and any type of domination. Yeah, just click on that button there. All right, Merry Christmas, everybody. We're going to be doing some great things down the sewer next year. Don't forget that the dark sewer scientists have more power than the federal government do today. Merry Christmas, everybody. Bye.
Acid jazz. El Circulo de Willis.
the vivid and shocking portrayal of modern youth who grow up too soon and live it up too fast.
You'll never make it!
Wild for Kicks, the daring motion picture that takes you behind the scenes in a world where anything goes. A world of beat girls and defiant boys, Wild for Kicks. Introducing singing star Adam Faith and the new screen sensation Gillian Hill with a supporting cast of new and exciting young stars.
It's a fan of Matt.
Hey, there's a train coming. Let's play chicken on the rail.
For Kicks, starring David Farrar as the man with the problem daughter, beautiful French star Noelle Adam as the new and very loving wife, and Christopher Lee as the man who makes a living from a striptease clip joint. It's Wild, 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 Wild for Kicks, a motion picture that will leave you breathless.
Nicole! Come in!
Every now and then, a cycling tourist will tell me about how they got lost on one of these meandering trails that would just go off into the woods, and then they'd be lost. And they'd be looking around like, fuck, where the hell did I come from? And then they would hear a bicycle bell, and it sounds just like that. But it doesn't stop there. There's so many unofficial bike paths in and around Spearfish and Tinton Road that even I, fuck, hang on a second, disregard that one, fuck.
Hey, Nick, it's me again. Really great show again, man. You're doing really good. And hey, it's great to hear from Zindu again. Yeah, I was worried about him, man. It's good that he's back. Yeah, we really like that guy. Well, my wife loved them. I mean, 17 penises. Wow. An interesting prospect. Anyway,
bless you, caller.
Joke for you. So get ready, because here she comes. What's the difference between a really dirty bus stop and a lobster with large breasts? One of them is a crusty bus station. Think about it. Get back to me. Great show, Nick.
I think I got it. I think I got, maybe I don't. Woo. So the news, I think I saw this on Twitter. The Earth's magnetic field. Let's go to Twitter and type in this key. Search Twitter, paste Earth's magnetic field, search latest. Let's go to latest. No, it's not there. Let's go to my previously searched. This is on Business Insider. Catherine Tenaglagalis Lippert. Let's look up Catherine Tenaglagalis Clifford. Okay, there's her Business Insider. She's got a Twitter. She does have a Twitter. And so many people on Twitter follow her. She's got a check mark. She does have a check mark. She has 345 followers. I have more followers than her. She retweeted something about Kanye West. For $15,000 and a signed NDA, students at Kanye unaccredited Donda Academy. They start the day with a full school worship before a parkour in Richmond class. The Donda Academy. Donda is his musical instrument. The little, like a four-button loop machine. I heard it's pretty cool. I'm probably simplifying it a lot. I've never used the Donda, but it is a music device. I think there's four buttons, and it does loops that you can load into each of the buttons. It's actually not a bad device from what I've heard, but there's a school for it. I can't afford a $15,000 school. I don't think any kid could. Probably like a rich person's daycare. Because like if you have $1 billion or $1 million or $33 trillion, you could afford Kanye West's Donda Academy. And your kid will probably learn a lot about making music and how to be fit. Because you have to be fit to do parkour in Richmond class. All right, I'm way off topic here. This is maybe I should follow her. Wait, no, the next retweet was from August 18th. I was like, hold on one second. Person, that article I'm quoting right now has 345 followers, says blue check mark. I'm not going to even spend $8 for a blue check mark. on Nick the Rat. Maybe I'll do it for a month to see if it gets me followers. You know what? As soon as Elon makes the $8 a month blue check mark available, I'll buy it. I'll be transparent about my Twitter followers. I've been on Twitter since it's almost been invented. I was against it from since it's almost been invented. I use it, but I'm not 100% me while I'm using it. It's a different version of me when I use Twitter. There is a Twitter version of Nick the Rat. Nick the Rat Radio is pretty damn close to me because, fuck, this is, hey, hi. Pretty damn close. I get drunk off cheap beer and then hold my pinky up when I drink some water. Wait, where am I? Listen to the haunting audio of Earth's magnetic field released by the European Space Agency, October 30th. So she made this article and didn't tweet about it, but she has a blue check mark. This is the news. All right, you ready for news? It got posted on Yahoo, but it's a Business Insider. Yahoo, fucking, what is this? What the fuck? Fuck journalism. Journalism has been dead for fucking long. Okay, look. Journalism's dead. The closest thing you could get to journalism is like No Agenda or Joe Rogan or DH Unplugged. A podcast. But the podcast can't have advertisements. Alex Jones is on an extreme side of this because he goes way overboard, but has advertisements. Joe Rogan is an advertiser. He's an interesting fella. I have questions I'd like to ask Joe Rogan about that I don't know his true response to. My main would be like I would like to know his biggest difference between being skinny Joe to athletic Joe would be. And if he believes in aliens and Bigfoot and shadow people. They're real. Let's listen to some artist's representation of a magnetic field on Earth via audio being reported to Yahoo News or Business Insider via Catherine Tangalakis Lippert, who has 500 followers on Twitter, but a blue check mark. Here we go. The scary sound of Earth's magnetic field, European Space Agency, on SoundCloud. This is science. Not haunting, this is not chain crane lifting, this is science. This is Cthulhu, yes, yeah, Cthulhu. That's I watched more into this. The main pusher for this is some dude. Some dude, probably 35. He's like, whoa, man. We got a cool setup of like 32 fucking speakers around this area so you can listen to this. So science is basically ASMR frauds taking money from your pocket, confiscated by your government. You can't follow the money. You pay taxes, and your tax money pays for this. This is science. Well, this is in Europe, so I don't know. Do Europeans pay taxes? Is that, did that survive the Revolutionary War? Was that a like an infection from Europe? Did the kings make their serfs, their peons? Oh wait, this is still going. This is long. Mother Earth is an ASMR tool. Scientists. Science. That's
I have a normal boring job cleaning up bathroom stalls at the local strip joint. While I'm doing this, I like to listen to my favorite podcasts. Some of those include the Nick the Rat radio podcast with Nick the Rat. He's weird. There's the No Agenda show with Adam Curry and John C. Dvorak where they deconstruct news. I like those guys. There's Dvorak Horowitz and DH Unplugged and they talk about the stock market. You can invest today. I'm trying to get out of this job, so I'm going there. When I'm done with those, sometimes I listen to Life Bites. They're a bunch of pineapple fuckers, though, so I don't know, it kind of gets me out of the mood of my job cleaning the spooge up in the toilets over here. And don't forget a Cat in a Box podcast. They hold those mental viewing parties. They try to, like, target something and find it with your mind. Blows me away. And when I need to come back down to Earth, I like to listen to A Walk Through the Mind with Billy Bones. He's really fun guy. He's got a lot of opinions there. You know who else has got opinions? Steak. You wouldn't think so, but Cruising with Steak has got a lot of opinions that are... I really hold up on a high pedestal. I listen to them all the time. And then don't forget, one of the best podcasts that was ever come out of Canada is gonna be Grimerica, definitely. I've never learned so much about Bigfoot in my life if it wasn't for these guys. Let me tell you, it makes my job cleaning up the lipstick off the wall really, really much more enjoyable for me. So yeah, I just wanted to say, you know, if you got the internet and a cellular device or some type of listening thing, you should tune into these podcasts and see what you think. And then, you know, go back to cleaning up the shit stains in the bathroom, wherever your job is. Thanks.
You want a cool AI for you? Because I don't think AI is real. It's basically stealing from what exists. All the art generators that are coming out recently, which are they're fucking amazing. A cat playing volleyball in a bikini on the beach. You're gonna get a picture of a cat playing volleyball in a bikini on the beach. But if you want to hear my dead relatives talking to me, we're close to that. Will it be coherent talking to you? No, it will not be coherent. It'll be pretty fucking obscure. But imagine this over like 10 years. Imagine training an AI bot that's doing what it needs to do to try to fool you. After 10 years, we might have this kind of technology in 2020. So in like 2030, we might have AI bots that are that can almost replace your friends. I'm willing to say that you could create a friend within 10 years, because a friend is just somebody that knows the shit you know. Like, hey, remember that time that you did this? Oh yeah. Oh.
Hello there, Nick the Rat. I do remember the last time that you and me played that video game, and we almost lost, but then we had an experience where we came together and we won. Do you remember Nick the Rat? I do. I was there.
But after like 10 years of being with this thing, you'd be like, hey, robot, remember that time? It was Halloween. I was drunk and I didn't know where I was going. And then I was like, hey, robot.
Well, yes. And then you went to the store to get another 40 ounce of Old English. You used your credit card. I remember this. Your password back then for your credit card account was very different than it is now, but I know all of your passwords. Anyway, I'm a fucking robot. Guess what? I know everything you've told me, and I can read it back to you, because it's like a ping-pong fucking echo chamber.
Look, the echo chamber, you could create your own echo chamber, and I think the echo chamber you could create can become very convincing after 10 years. Fuck that talking to your dead app. That's like live journal. Some bullshit. Anyway, come back next week and hang out with Nick the Rat, and we'll have a fun time when it's midnight in your sewer. Whatever that time is. If you don't take anything away from the episode of Nick the Rat Radio, at least take away the music and go support these artists. Go to my SoundCloud /like/ Nick the... What? And tell them you enjoyed, you like the, it was like Adderall, which is speed, which is, and methamphetamines or methamphetamines, and it's legal. Woo! Self-control. Red Ray, good night, everybody. Be back next week.
Many unofficial bike paths in and around Spearfish and Kitten Road that even if you or me wandered here for 100 years, that we would never know them all. Yeah, every now and again, a cycling tourist would tell me about how they got lost on one of these meandering trails, and then they would hear a bicycle bell. And when they look, they see a strange light. And it's always, it would always lead them back to the Spearfish bypass. And when the last cyclist reaches the path, the boy points north, enters town, and then disappears.
How many you figure in here?
God, the size of this hill could be thousands, I guess.
You want to know how many's in this hill? I'll show you how many's in that damn hill.
Don't kill the animals. Rats have rights.